I asked her, when did it start? She said, I think I was about 7 or 8 years old when it first started. And I said, why'd you wait so long to say something? And she said, I didn't want to lose my dad.
Amber, her daughter Sabrina, and her niece Isabella all knew Kendra Checkey from an early age.
A heartwarming person, very energetic. Yeah, she was just an amazing person. She had an amazing personality.
She was always laughing. She always kept a smile on her face the whole time.
12-year-old Kendra Checkey died January 15th when she was struck and killed by a truck on I-80 while she chased after a friend. The two had been staying at the Children's Receiving Home of Sacramento.
She couldn't even breathe because she was crying so hard, and it's just, that little girl, her life was just cut way too short. And sure enough, you know, she left this world saving somebody else.
Her father, Kerwin Glenn Checkey, had been arrested less than a year earlier and charged with 12 counts of rape and sexual abuse against his own daughter. Amber, Sabrina, and Isabella said Kendra had begun telling them what happened before she died.
When I talked to her about it, I believed her right away.
Yeah,
you could see the hurt in her eyes when she first started talking about it. I told her, I said, Kendra, honey, that none of this is your fault. And she felt so guilty for breaking up her family.
When she told me what happened, she also told me that two other girls got whatever.
You can say the words.
Okay, raped. She have told me two other girls got raped.
Are you saying that there could be other victims in this?
Yes, she has told me that there was two other victims that has got raped.
By Glenn?
By Glenn. I was at my Aunt Amber's, and me and Sabrina were on FaceTime with her for like about 3 hours. And then when Sabrina walked away, I said, was it you or more girls? And she says it was two other girls, and they were my friends, and we were really close.
Does that make you concerned about the people that he was around, the other kids that he was around?
Yeah, it makes me concerned. She always had friends going to spend the night, and I'm just so happy that I'm such a strict mom that Sabrina never really got to go there and spend the night or nothing.
Amber says this is why they're speaking out, because they believe there could be other victims out there. Police say they are unaware of additional alleged victims, but encourage anyone with information to give them a call. Glenn Checkey coached and was on the board of the Junior Mavericks Youth Football League.
It was our Maverick family, and we were always close. We would always work in snack bars together.
Yeah, he was a coach. He was like a regular dad. I mean, we all like looked up to them as far as with our children.
So what do you guys want to see now? What would you like to happen?
I hope that he has to pay for what he's done. And I hope that if there are more victims,
they come
forward, because that would make a world of difference, especially because she's not here to speak for herself anymore.
I reached out to Checkey's attorney for comment, but have not heard back.